Welcome to this latest episode of the C-Suite podcast from the Arabian Travel Market here in Dubai. We're producing this episode in partnership with Cinnamon Life, the largest integrated resort in South Asia. We've got some excellent conversations coming up. Really hope you enjoy the show. Okay, I'm here with Mikael Svensson, who is the CEO of Cinnamon Hotel and Resorts. Mikael, lovely to see you.
Great to be here, thank you.
Yeah, no problem at all. Now we're here at the Arabian Travel Market 2024. Yeah. What are your first impressions of the event to start off with?
I have to say, first and foremost, it's just great to see the energy in the halls. We were here obviously last year, but it's just elevated to another level and everybody's positive and everybody's excited. Maybe that's helped by the fact that we have great news and we have great energy and a great story to tell about Cinnamon. So no, it's been wonderful to see.
Well, let's move on to that great news, yeah, because you're here to talk about Cinnamon Life at City of Dreams Sri Lanka, which opens later this year. Very exciting.
That's right.
Launch is fast approaching.
It is.
What are your
indeed.
Thoughts now?
It is indeed. Well, it keeps me up at night.
Yeah, sure.
But we're very, very excited. Obviously, we announced our collaboration with City of Dreams and Melco just last week. And, this was always the plan in the making. You know, when we looked at what we wanted to develop, it was much bigger than what a hotel project is or an integrated resort. It was about finding the right partner that could really drive the economy and drive a different level of focus into Colombo and into Sri Lanka. So very exciting, absolutely.
Yeah, now projects evolve over time, don't they? Mm. Take me back to the beginning. What was in your head? What was the original concept behind this resort?
Yeah, the beginning was way before my time, about 10 years ago. The area in which Cinnamon Life and the integrated resort has been developed was owned by John Keel, so it's our land. And at the time they were looking at what can we create that can be a game changer for the country. Mm. What can we create for Cinnamon? Mm. It was about what do we do?
That's the key difference, isn't
it? That's the key difference, is really about how do we take this and make it a game changer for the country, and essentially, it will obviously be a game changer for us, and very unlike anything that we have in our portfolio. So that was really the thinking about, and when I came in 5 years ago, the main objective for me was, how do we make this an international, world-class integrated resort? What do we need to do to differentiate us, to make ourselves stand up and be counted on the absolute international level?
You might be able to guess my follow-up question.
Yeah.
How do you do that?
Yeah, well, there's a lot. I think, first and foremost, it's about identifying key talent. Mm-hmm. And really understanding what do we want and what type of people do we want to bring this message and to drive this message to reality. Mm-hmm. Because anybody can build a $1.3 billion hotel if they have the money. Yeah. Not everybody can, but if you have the money, you can. But in the end of the day, there's no soul in a building. Mm-hmm. The soul comes from the people. Mm-hmm. And what you want to deliver in hotels always come from people. Mm-hmm. So for me, it was about finding key people to establish the right kind of synergies within Cinnamon Hotels and Resorts and Cinnamon Life. Mm-hmm. Because for me, it was not about, well, we have this amazing project, let's bring this to fruition, and then what happens with the rest of the company. So really, I constantly say that Cinnamon Life, for me, was the sieve mm-hmm. for creating the standards and the impressions and the future of what Cinnamon Hotels and Resorts is. So we've really been able to use this amazing platform as a sieve to sort of then implement the greatness of what Cinnamon Hotels and Resorts is creating.
Sure. What about Sri Lanka in particular then, and Sri Lankan culture? What does that bring to this whole project?
That's the cornerstone of the brand. I mean, I just spoke about the people mm-hmm. and what you have to do to get the soul and the DNA of a hotel company in a project. But Sri Lanka is, essentially what Cinnamon Hotels and Resorts and Cinnamon Life is all about. Our purpose is bringing the best of Sri Lanka to the world with style and elegance. That's what we stand for, and that's what we intend to do, and that's what we have been doing. And very interesting because, the Sri Lankan hospitality is natural. You don't have to teach it. It's in the fingertips. But then you bring something like Cinnamon Life, which is extremely modern. Mm-hmm. So it's almost a juxtaposition in a way. Yeah. But it's how you then bring the soul of Sri Lanka into this extremely, you know, modern, futuristic hotel and complex. Mm-hmm. And you marry those two, and I think you've got magic.
Yeah. Well, you're talking about integration there. Let's go back a step to the Arabian travel market, which, as I said, we're here today. So what kind of trends are you seeing? How does Cinnamon Life fit into those trends?
I mean, obviously, one of the big trends that's always there is, and I'm not going to say buzzword, but sustainability and ecotourism. But I feel that Sri Lanka kind of can own that. Mm. Because, you know, we've had ecotourism in our bloods for way before that became a trend.
It sounds like that's something you do almost instinctively.
Absolutely. Yeah. It is what we do instinctively, and it's sort of a cornerstone of what we do. And not only as a country, but the destinations in which we have hotels and projects in which we associate ourselves with always has to do with how we can evolve this message through our properties or through the various engagements that we have. So that's obviously something that we're seeing a lot of here. I think also people are trying to see what new things can come around, what new kind of developments. This is day one, so it'll be interesting to go around and really understand what's on the plate for WOW. We're obviously in Dubai. Dubai does the upside down and the inside outs, right? This is what you expect of this place. So it'll be very interesting to see how companies are moving forward.
Yeah. Now, from a personal experience, obviously, with your background in luxury hotels and various brands, how have you seen the market evolving? Is it getting ever more difficult to have that point of difference, to stay ahead of the crowd?
Yeah, it is. And I mean, if I may, I kind of have seen the way that the evolution of luxury, at least in my eyes, you know, in my 30 odd years in the industry, you know, when I first joined, luxury was very much about, you know, Mr. and Mrs. Svensson and giving very, very unique and service where you don't really invade their privacy. And it's all about luxury, and you better be putting that cup down at 45 degree angle, and everything needs to be polished and perfect. That's what it was, you know. That was luxury at that time. Then we evolved into a period where technology became luxury, and it was all about speed and connectivity, and how fast and what kind of gadgets that you had. And then lastly, you know, we've now come to a stage where the social media aspect is out. So you couldn't be more different from where you started, because now it's, you better call them Mikael and not Mr. Svensson.
Yeah.
And you better know that they have a Chihuahua and they have, you know,
really
what kind of car they drive. And so, because that's what luxury is. And if you don't know that, why don't you know that about me? So we really come from this privacy side of luxury, of absolute privacy, to luxury of knowing everything and being personal. So I think that it'll be interesting to see where we evolve from there. But I think throughout this journey, the most important thing is have amazing product, have amazing service, and have amazing quality. Those will always be at the forefront of any luxury experience.
Sure. Okay, let's finish up with, let's bring this back to Cinnamon Life at City of Dreams, Sri Lanka.
Yeah.
As I said, launch is fast approaching.
Yeah.
What does success look like for you over the next 3 years, do you think?
First and foremost, we want to see those tourism numbers double, if not more. That's the intention for me. That's the intention for the project. And I know that's the intention for the economy and tourism of Sri Lanka. So that would be first and foremost. I think secondly, that brands, not just ours, but every hotel brand, you know, raises their game and drives hospitality through brand, not through price. You know, hotels exist because of brand, not because of price. But we've been faced with difficult times in Sri Lanka, so we've had no choice but to drive the industry through price. So going back to being able to see that we're really driving our brand and others through price. And lastly, investment, being able to see some other great brands that are out there and smaller brands and developing the industry and being able to grow the industry, that would be just great. So I think the responsibility is way beyond what we're developing and what we're going to give. We want to make sure that the industry and the country goes with us.
Well, it's been a fascinating journey thus far, hasn't it? And I'm
Absolutely.
Sure it will continue to have thrills and spills. So, Mikael Svensson, thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you very much. Thanks for taking time. It's been great.
Yeah, pleased to say that I'm now here with Suresh Rajendra, who is the President Leisure Group at John Keells Group. Suresh, how are you today?
Lovely, fantastic, thank you.
Yeah, and how is ATM for you? How are you enjoying it?
I think it's been fantastic so far. Yeah, the good activity out here, the number of people. Yeah. I think it's getting busy and busy every year. And I'm actually thrilled to see our Sri Lankan counters really active. Including our stall, the cinnamon stall out here. Yeah. I think it's fantastic, and I think it's getting better and better and bigger.
Now, we've been talking a lot today about the John Keells Group investment in Cinnamon Life, which is set to transform Colombo, isn't it? Transform Sri Lanka as a whole. So tell us a bit more about how that investment came about and what it involves.
Okay. It was always the vision of the John Keells Group to make Colombo like a center for lifestyle and entertainment for the South Asian region. Yep. And that's what we really wanted to do. When we set off, we actually wanted to build an icon in the city of Colombo, what like the opera house is to Sydney, for that matter. Okay, so people will recognize the city of Colombo through what we have kind of built. And I think that is what we wanted to do, and I believe that is what we have achieved in building this fantastic property. It's just more than the property now. It's about what it's actually bringing to the city. And I'm proud to say that it will create a transformation. It's already creating a transformation to the city. As you can see today, people are getting that much more aware of Sri Lanka and the city of Colombo. So Sri Lanka has traditionally been a resort and culture-based tourism product. But now we are actually opening out the city as well. And the city of Colombo is one beautiful city.
Yeah.
Graham, I don't know whether you've been there.
No, I haven't. I'd love to go. Yeah.
Okay. It's one beautiful city, and there's so much of culture and so much of character in that city. And we'll be proud to actually bring that out to the world through both our product and the experience that we'll create around it. So it's been a big investment. It's been a very ambitious, very daring project. We probably ran through some of the hardest and the most challenging times in this whole construction.
Yeah.
I don't think there's ever been a more challenging time in the near past or the distant past for that matter. So we're very happy to see it coming now to its ultimate fruition, and we're ready to go.
I mean, it's a billion-plus investment, isn't it? And I can't imagine there are many such investments like that around the world, are there? This must be pretty unique at the current time.
Yeah, I know. I really don't have the stats, but I think from what I know, there's not been a bigger opening in the world since COVID. For sure. I can't think of. I know there was one here in Dubai, but almost about the same valuation, the same value. But it's probably one of the biggest openings of a hotel that has taken place.
And do you feel this is kind of just desserts for Colombo? That this has been a long time coming, and it's this time to deliver for the people, the country.
Absolutely, it is. And I think I'm all excited that there are some other big properties like the ITC Sheraton has also opened up. So that Colombo is suddenly getting noticed as a destination for the region.
Yeah.
And we're very, very happy to be at the forefront of it. We have more properties in the city of Colombo. We actually, the Cinnamon Group, have more than about 30% of the room inventory in the city of Colombo.
Yeah.
So we are a big part of Colombo, and we're happy to be there.
Yeah. What does it mean for, let's look at the economic side of things. What does it mean for the local economy and for jobs, things like that?
I mean, in addition to the direct job creation that this project will bring about, possibly around 3,000 or more, the indirect job creation will be multiples of that.
Wow.
And that is something that will be huge, in addition to the kind of activity it creates, the procurement, the purchasing that will take place. It's another huge foreign exchange generator for the country.
Yeah.
And the country needs this foreign exchange really badly, as you would have heard in the recent past and the crisis that we have had. So it could be a big part of the economy. I dare say it will, you know, take our GDP up by a few notches.
And does this become a catalyst as well for further change? Is that what generally happens? Once a big investment like this comes in, then other investment soon follows?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we've seen what big integrated resorts in the region have done to those countries. Mm. I mean, you take some of the examples that are out there and how that has actually changed and created a whole ecosystem around those projects. And that will definitely be the case.
Yeah. What do you see as, let's just talk more generally about the kind of future of tourism, if you like, and what people's expectations are for travel nowadays. Do you have any thoughts on that?
Yeah, because now you can see more and more people are deciding very quickly and traveling quickly after the decision, right?
Yeah. That long lead time.
And also, we see that they are looking for more experiences, experiential tourism, right? So they need activity, and you need to have, you know, everything that is thrown in that will, you know, create that excitement.
Yeah.
So this is really, you know, getting the tourism, the holidays becoming that much more dynamic.
Yeah.
And that's what we are catering through projects like this.
Yeah, and on the C-Suite podcast, we're particularly interested in the C-Suite. So what about corporate travel? I mean, how do you see that changing, and how do you cater for today's business travel?
Yes, I mean, business travel was a very big part of our traveling to the city of Colombo, but we saw that dipping soon after the COVID. Yep. We saw people actually not traveling, but it's picking up again, and that goes hand in hand with the economic development that is happening. And Colombo is also transforming. There's a lot more investment coming to the city of Colombo that brings in business travel. Then the MICE market is a huge market, and we are sitting right next door to India. Mm-hmm. And India, as you know, is a huge market in itself. The traveling market there is very big. The corporate travel from India is huge, and it gives us immense opportunities. But Colombo didn't have all the facilities. And through projects of this nature, we actually are bringing in the conferencing facilities that will enable us to target those markets, and also the product to actually cater to those markets.
Right.
And I think that in that context, the MICE market did play, but now it will play a huge part of tourism into the city.
Yeah. Well, let's just finish up by talking about the launch, because that is rapidly approaching, isn't it?
Yes.
So
yes.
Can you believe that you've actually got to this point, and how excited are you?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's been a long journey.
Yeah.
It's been a long journey of almost like 10 years since the time we started off.
Yeah.
But what we've seen is we've actually seen the original vision now actually becoming reality. And that's the greatest excitement. We got some wonderful partners who have come on board with us, and that's actually made that more exciting. So we will be opening this hotel, the Cinnamon Life Hotel within the City of Dreams, by about August this year, and a full opening very early, sometime next year.
Yeah. We will keep a very close eye on that, Suresh Rajendra. So thanks so much for joining me and telling me all about it, and enjoy the rest of the time at the show.
You're very welcome, and thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
I'm here with Kamal Munasinghe, who is the Area Vice President Colombo at Cinnamon Hotel and Resorts. Kamal, lovely to see you here.
Lovely to see you too. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Not at all. So how are you enjoying Arabian travel market to start with?
I think it's a great platform. I think it's going for the 32nd year, as far as I know.
Yeah.
I read about it, right? I think it has evolved over the years. This is my first time coming to Arabian travel.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, yes, yes. By coming here, I just wanted to see, you know, what is out there, what's the market like. And it's a short-haul destination, you know, for Colombo, from Middle East, from Dubai. And I see a great potential, I think, you know.
Yeah.
And I met a lot of partners who we can work with, lots of new ideas to be bounced off, and, you know, see, understanding new trends as well, you know, from this part of the world, how they're looking at travel and what they're looking at, or what they consider when they go to, when they decide on a destination to visit. So there are lots of learnings, a lot of new technology, lot of AI-driven technology has been introduced in the arena. I had the opportunity to talk to a couple of people who are introducing. Actually, it's travel it's AI-driven travel-based solutions, which I think very helpful in the run of going for more business and you know driving business. And also automation, you know, for hotel automation. That's not so much in this at ATM, but more about how you can drive targeted business to your own products. You know, so that's been an interesting 2 days so far.
Yeah, sounds good. Now it's been a very busy day here, hasn't it? From a Sri Lankan perspective, we've had the Sri Lankan tourism minister. Well, we've interviewed him here on the new podcast for Cinnamon Life. And I understand you've just been to the press conference, haven't you? So could you tell me a little bit more about that and what was discussed?
Yeah, it was more about one of the main things that he announced is the agreement that he signed with Emirates Airlines. They are increasing the frequency, flight frequency to 4 flights a day, which is 3 at the moment, and it's going to go to 5 in the month of December. And they're adding an A380, which for the first time, I think, from Dubai to Colombo. So it's a great news because the seat capacity is very, very important when it comes to tourism, you know, when you're promoting the destination. And I think Dubai will not have not enough seat capacity by hearing this news, you know. So this is one of the main things that that he talked about. He also talked about, of course, our own project, Cinnamon Life, City of Dreams, and how excited he is about it. About the whole project coming to Sri Lanka, and you know that John Keels is investing into the industry to make it a destination, you know. So he sounded very positive about the future outlook of tourism, and he's also the minister for lands. So he invited investors to come and invest, and if anyone needs lands, he's the one to talk to about. I think overall it's a very positive message that came out from the minister as well as the delegation. We are very hopeful because, you know, if you look at it 18 months ago, Sri Lanka was in a very different spot when it comes to tourism. I was in the midst of that because our hotels are in the middle of Colombo. So we saw what happened 18 months ago, and then we saw a rapid increase of arrivals over the last 18 months. We went up to about 1.7 million tourist arrivals just within a period of 12 to 14 months. You know,
how did you do that? You know, what you put that down to? Is that just the resilience of the Sri Lankan people?
So one main thing that comes to, you know, everyone's mouth is resilience. You know, the nation, Sri Lanka as a nation is a very resilient nation. And we have been through many, many difficulties, 30 years of war, a long time ago in 2010, and then you can talk about the Easter bombing, you know, all that. But, you know, Sri Lanka has always bounced back very, very fast. But this time around, it has been very quick to come back. I think one thing is the current administration, including the tourism minister and the team, has done a fantastic job. Of course, the private investors, the industry companies like Cinnamon Hotels and Resorts are doing quite a lot of work in terms of promoting the destination. So it has all come back very well. And it's, I think, four of everything that we put in onto the table, and that has a ripple effect of, you know, driving the destination, as a tourist destination.
Because the investment really is a game changer for, well, certainly Colombo, but Sri Lanka as a whole, isn't it? Would you say that?
Absolutely, absolutely. Because when you look at it, you know, Sri Lanka as a, I mean, if you look at just Colombo itself, reclaimed land, port city, you know, is right there. It's just completed the project, you know, now we are looking for investors to come and invest. There are lots of development happening in the port city. Port city itself has added multiple activities for people who are visiting Colombo when it comes to, in terms of food and beverage offerings, horseback riding, you know, the a beach right in the middle of Colombo, you know, beach clubs. They just opened another beach club just a week ago, you know. So there's lots of activities taking place at Port City itself, which is a good attraction for people who are visiting Colombo. You know, it's always good to have those kind of activities going in a city like that. And Port City gives us that perfect, you know, opportunity. And so, of course, you know, Port City is a great place to invest as well for anybody who wants to look at investing into the country.
Yeah. Now, we've heard a lot about the Cinnamon City of Dreams, Sri Lanka today. Tell me about the other properties in Colombo, the other Cinnamon properties in Colombo. How do they fit into the mix?
Cinnamon has three hotels.
Okay.
In Colombo, Cinnamon Grand, Cinnamon Lakeside, and Cinnamon Red. Mm-hmm. Cinnamon Grand is the first of its own. Okay. The brand was originated with Cinnamon Grand Hotel almost 20 plus years ago.
Okay.
The hotel has been in existence for the last 50 years. So next year we are celebrating the 50th year of existence of the building.
Okay.
And we have one of the oldest fine dining restaurant, London Grill, at Cinnamon Grand, which is going to be 50 next year. Started with Oberoi at that time, and then it continued the journey, you know, up until now, and then it's going to go into next year with his 50th birthday.
Oh, wow.
So we'll have a great celebration.
What's the speciality dish there?
It's a steak restaurant.
Okay.
So we focus mainly on steak, and it is the oldest fine dining steak restaurant.
That's
in
amazing.
The city. Yeah.
Yeah.
So when it comes to the three hotels in Colombo, you know, the Cinnamon Grand is more the business hotel.
Okay.
If you look at the entire inventory of Cinnamon as of now, without Cinnamon Life, we hold about 1,000 keys. Multiple venues for conferences, MICE events, weddings, destination weddings. And then our Cinnamon Red is more the three-star hotel, express service, where you have one restaurant, one bar,
sure.
And super good bed to sleep.
Yeah.
You know? It's mainly, you know, business people who come in to the town for one or two nights,
yeah,
get their things done, and then
yep.
brief stay, and then they go back. Cinnamon Lake is located in front of a lake, as you can say by the name, you know. It's more the leisure hotel, so it's the resort in the city, actually. They have we have multiple leisure activities based at the hotel. It has the largest membership mm-hmm. That Colombo has to offer in that hotel called Library Membership, you know. So all the elites are members of this hotel and this club.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it has its own segments for these three hotels.
Caters for different needs.
Yeah. Correct.
And you mentioned business travel quite a few times there. It'd be good to pick up on that point and talk to me a little bit about how you feel that corporate travel, business travel is changing maybe.
Yeah.
The expectations that business travelers have.
Yeah, I think, you know, since of COVID, you can see there's less and less business travel compared to before, but there's still, after COVID, we could see that, you know, the urge for travel has come back also because for 2 years, you know, there's pent-up demand, right?
Yeah.
People were just hungry to travel. I think they made it a reason to travel right after that.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to corporate travel, you know, however much you want to do, maybe online work and, you know, there's still a lot of travel happening to the destination when it comes to investment opportunities. We have a lot of people traveling on different requirements, on diplomatic reasons, because, you know, Sri Lanka is going through a lot of discussions, negotiations with IMF, etc., etc. So the World Bank travel, IMF travel, the embassies have quite a bit of travel coming to Sri Lanka, and then of course the projects driving travel into Sri Lanka. So Cinnamon Grand is actually the hub for business travel, purely because of its location. We are just right next to actually Cinnamon Life, just 2 kilometers
okay.
down the road.
Right. Yeah.
Actually, all our hotels are within a radius of 5 kilometers.
Is that right? Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
So yeah, location is great.
Yeah.
And then the offerings of Cinnamon Grand is very, very good for business traveler because the main reason is you have the multiple meeting options, a great business lounge for the travelers. As well, multiple restaurants. We have about 10 different restaurants within the hotel.
Okay.
We are the largest F&B
operation
at the moment.
Do you have a favorite restaurant of those 10 restaurants?
So there are actually, okay, if I have to name one.
Come on, you have to name one. I'm going to pin you down here.
The seafood.
Okay.
The seafood restaurant.
Yeah.
That's called Lagoon. It's like you're going to the market in Sri Lanka, you know.
Nice.
The freshest seafood that you can get. off the shelf, and then you can ask the chef to make the way you want it to be prepared, in what kind of sauce you want to have it, and you get the freshest seafood.
Great. Okay, just to sum up, maybe for me, just answer me one final question. Why Colombo and why now?
Yeah, I think why Colombo is a very important question. Colombo is an up-and-coming destination. There's multiple activities for a traveler, even if you come on business travel. You know, if you find some leisure time, there's plenty of things to do in Colombo. For example, we just talked about this as well. In the sea, in the area of Colombo, you have hundreds of shipwrecks lying there from World War II.
Okay, so for diving.
So you can dive.
Yeah.
In 3 days, you can get your diving license, for example.
Yeah.
If you are a diver, right? Or if you want to do bird watching, it's just a 20-minute ride to the suburbs, and then you can do a bird watching tour.
Nice.
While you do your business. When it comes to wellness, there's plenty of wellness options that's available. When it comes to food and beverage offerings, multiple food and beverage offerings. You know? So it's a really nice city, as it's a green city. You know, when you come to Colombo, it's not like a city where you see buildings after buildings. You know?
No.
It's a city properly arranged, perfectly designed, I think. You know, and also you have a lot of green. Just drive 5 minutes out of the city, not even 5 minutes out of the city, you will drive into the greenery. You know? So you are still with the nature, but in a vibrant city.
You've sold it to me very well. I think it's time I bought
that
ticket.
I'm going to see you soon then.
you will indeed.
Okay.
Kamal Munasinghe, thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
It was a pleasure. Thanks again to all the guests who took the time to come and speak with me here on Cinnamon Life Stand at the Arabian Travel Market in Dubai. You can find the C-Suite podcast on all the usual social media channels. And if you'd like to get in touch with the show, you can do that via the contact form on the website. But for now, thanks for listening and goodbye.